Good evening. I am pleased that you have come to our little show. Tonight, my friends, you can witness the wild, wacky terror of spooky space. Yes, I know. You are expecting a pleasant night under the stars, and you will, with the stars of Halloween. Witches. Zombies. And ghosts. You will also meet their far more terrible counterparts in space. After this, the night sky will never look the same to you again. Come, my friends. The night awaits you. The night of Halloween. Look toward the night sky, but this time with Halloween rhymes. Can your imaginations spot scary constellations, cosmic creatures, or celestial trick or treaters? Look deeper through big telescopes. Seen any nebulous ghosts? How about a witch's face? Way out here in deep, deep space. What is that red creepy crawly? Maybe a spider looking at me. That's a picture of a star, our very own sun. Anyone see a pumpkin looking for fun? The Heavens Harbor Halloween Connections. Just expand your spacey perceptions. Look, the moon, La Luna, shining like a polished bone. Its powerful light is said to influence all kinds of wild things, like the werewolf, the hapless victim of the full moon. Or a flying witch, who, it is said, has her best magical power underneath a big moon. What about tales of lunacy? When someone acts a little loony, how often do we say, there must be a full moon tonight? Some believe more babies are born on a full moon night. Some think more crimes happen when the moon waxes to full. And yet, none of these moon myths have any basis in fact. What does the moon cause? The tides? The moon's gravity pulls water from the Earth's near side more than the water from the far side. This difference creates the low and high tides around the Earth. A gorgeous moon also triggers our creative imaginations. It inspires us to song, poetry, art, books, movies. And finally, the moon fuels our curiosity. It leads us to science, to engineering. 12 astronauts have walked on the lunar surface. And maybe more someday. Maybe you? Ghosts. Spooky spirits of the dead. Who fly and frolic, dart and dance, and haunt the living. scaring us with their untimely appearances. Do ghosts have their counterparts in the starry night sky? We call them nebulae, ghostly remnants from dying stars. Enormous, billowing rings. These are celestial ghosts, the expanding, fleeting gas and dust shells that mark the end of a star. All stars will run out of fuel. Even our star, the Sun, will one day look something like this. When in 5 billion years, it exhausts all the hydrogen in its core. Giant stars live their life in the fast lane. Their nuclear cores end quickly. Suddenly, they expand outward in a supernova explosion. The star has collapsed, rebounding off its extremely dense iron core. The Crab Nebula, an excellent example of a stellar explosion that took place around 1,000 years ago. But not all nebulae are ethereal shrouds of dead stars. This is the Orion Nebula. Not a place of star death, but star birth. Thousands of stars will be born here. Some already have. These new baby stars illuminate this amazing nebula. Gaze upon the Eagle Nebula, the pillars of creation. The dark areas indicate deep, dense pockets of hydrogen. Hydrogen gets squeezed so tightly that eventually nuclear fusion will start and a star is born. Dedicated astronomers calmly explore all the ghostly nebulae to better understand the stars and ourselves. After all, we are made of stardust. We are golden. The invisible man. The spooky, sinister scientist. Yet, he's kind of chill. Is it possible to see the invisible man under a different type of light, like X-ray radiation? Did you know the universe is mostly invisible? These are not pictures we can see with human eyes, but with telescope eyes. Telescopes that collect energy beyond the boundaries of visible light from the entire EM, aka electromagnetic spectrum. Hotter objects produce gamma, X, and UV waves, while cooler things give off infrared, micro, and radio waves. Our eyeballs can detect less than 1% of the total energy and light coming from space. How's that for a far-out freaky fact? Deep down in the Sun's core, nuclear fusion forges all energies across the spectrum, from radio to gamma. Thanks to new solar scopes, we can observe and study this vast rainbow of invisible radiation. The entire electromagnetic spectrum is no longer an invisible mystery. Of all these energies streaming out from the Sun, the most abundant, based on temperature, is the narrow band we call visible light. To survive, human eyes have evolved to see only this part of the Sun's light, the dominant energy that feeds our Earth. flying on her broomstick, cackling her sorceress laugh. Today, she is a lovable Halloween character, dressed in black, with green skin, and a tall, pointy hat. She mixes her magical potions for casting malignant spells.
Dabble, dabble, toil and trouble. Fire burn and cauldron bubble. Mixing snakes, newts, and frogs of green. Making magic potions for Halloween.
Long ago, a witch was a scary outcast with links, they said, to the underworld. Did you know that Pluto, in ancient Roman mythology, was the god of the underworld? In Greek lore, his name was Hades. Pluto, the dwarf planet, is cold, 400 degrees below zero. Pluto is distant, about 4 billion miles from the sun. But Pluto is no longer dark. New images reveal an ice mountain 2 miles high. Vast icy plains, which some say give Pluto a big heart. These images came from NASA's New Horizons spacecraft, which needed a little gravity assist from Jupiter to slingshot itself all the way out to Pluto and its 5 moons. The total trip took almost 10 years, with an average speed of 10 miles a second. That's crazy fast. Pluto was discovered in 1930 by American Clyde Tombaugh in Flagstaff, Arizona, with this 13-inch telescope. The reason Pluto's planet status was taken away in 2006 was simply because astronomers were finding objects that resembled Pluto, small and icy, that gathered in an area called the Kuiper Belt. Instead of making these cold worlds planets, the largest ones became dwarf planets, including Pluto. The largest asteroid in the asteroid belt, Ceres, also became a dwarf planet. Pluto's demotion by the International Astronomical Union made headlines around the world. There are protests, petitions, and people everywhere are still a little miffed at this cosmic tragedy. But why? How did Pluto, the god of the underworld, ruler of the witches, ever get so popular? Is it the cool name, Pluto? Or maybe it's Disney's dog, or its small size, and people like rooting for the little guy, the underdog? Did Pluto get dogged?
Zombies.
The walking dead. They rise from their graves, brought back to life. Sort of, through magic. Or some scientific experiment gone wrong. They move with one thing on their brain.
Brains.
This is a zombie star. A star that explodes, but does not die. It's a sort of supernova. This one is called Eta Carina, or Eta Car. It's like a volcano in the sky. These gigantic, oofy clouds are stellar debris from several outbursts, each one equal to the blast of a small supernova. Eta Car is doomed to die, though. One day soon, astronomers assure us, it will go totally supernova. But only the big stars do this. Run through their fuel quickly, implode under the weight of gravity, and then explode as a supernova. Arcturus and Pollux are smaller stars. They will not explode. The outer layers will expand and make ghostly nebulae. Even tinier stars, like Sirius and our puny sun, will make nebulae one day. Let's get back to our zombie star, Eta Carina. As I mentioned, Eta Car is going to explode all the way as a supernova. Eta Car will soon be space toast. Is Earth in danger? Should we be scared? Breathe a sigh of relief, everyone. Eta Car's blast track is not aimed at Earth. Plus, the star is 7,500 light years distant. So, chill, my friends. We're good. Person is terrifying. It's the vampire
that wants to suck your blood.
Does the universe have its own version of the vampire? Why, yes. Yes, it does. We call it a black hole, a place where gravity will suck in anything that gets too close. Say a hapless star wanders too close. It gets ripped apart and sucked in by the black hole, the ultimate monster of the universe. Gravity is so severe here that time stops and space is inconceivable. Yes, I know what that word means. Say a curious astronaut moseys on by. The black hole's monstrous gravity will pull on whatever is closer more than what's further away, stretching this poor space person like a piece of spaghetti. Death by black hole, or spaghettification. A black hole is the remnant of a once large star that went supernova. The core squeezes upon itself, growing smaller and smaller, until finally it becomes a black hole. No one knows what's at the heart of these gigantic whirlpools of gravity. Could it lead somewhere? Back in time? Or to another part of the universe? A wormhole? The night grows late, my Halloween friends. Our little adventure is close to the end. Hope you enjoyed our stroll through spooky space. Come back to the planetarium for another cosmic chase. Next time, we'll have something different up our sleeve. Not just silly witches and ghosts flying around on
All Hallows Eve.
Thank you.
If the pull of a full moon frightens you, if you get alarmed by those eerie nebula, if you fear falling down an endless black hole, if Pluto's demotion still bothers you, please know, help is only a phone call away.
Hello, Spooky Space Hotline.
Oh, there's something kind of big and creepy hovering over my house. Looks to be a flying saucer of some sort.
Hello? Hello? Listen to that, Ted. Another UFO report. Jeepers creepers. We must be getting near Halloween.